If I were the man I was 5 years ago, I'd take a flamethrower to this place. Out of order. Who the hell do you think you're talking to? I've been around, you know. Boys like these, younger than these, their arms torn out, their legs ripped off. But there is nothing like the sight. No prosthetic for them. You think you're merely sending this splendid foot soldier back home to Argonne with his tail between his legs, but I say you are executing his soul. And why? Because he's not a bad man. Bad man. You hurt this boy, you're gonna be bad bums. The lot of you. And Harry, Jimmy, Trent, wherever you are out there, fuck you too.
Stand down, Mr. Slade.
I'm not finished. As I came in here, I heard those words. Cradle of leadership. Well, when the bow breaks, the cradle will fall. And it has fallen here. It has fallen. Makers of men, creators of leaders, be careful what kind of leaders you're producing here. I don't know if Charlie's silence here today is right or wrong, but I can tell you this. He won't sell anybody out to buy his future. And that, my friends, is called integrity. Now that's the stuff leaders should be made of. Now I have come to the crossroads in my life. I always knew what the right path was. Without exception, I knew. But I never took it. You know why? It was too damn hard. Now here's Charlie. He's come to the crossroads. He has chosen a path. It's the right path. Let him continue on his journey. You hold this boy's future in your hands, committee. It's a valuable future. Believe me. Don't destroy it. Protect it. Embrace it. It's gonna make you proud one day, I promise you.
随着弗兰克的话语落下，原本鸦雀无声的听证会突然爆发出震耳欲聋的掌声。校长在这一刻仿佛成了一个滑稽的小丑，他的权威和尊严被彻底颠覆。委员会被弗兰克的话语所触动，很快便做出了最终的决定，查理无需承担任何责任。而制作恶作剧的三人由于有危机嫌疑，暂时留校观察。乔治的行为也不给予表扬，台下再次响起震耳欲聋的掌声。他们不是在为查理鼓掌，而是将掌声送给了正直与勇气。当弗兰克与查理踏出那扇熟悉的校门，他们被一种前所未有的光辉所拥抱，阳光洒在他们身上，比任何时候都要灿烂，仿佛是大自然在为他们的未来铺就一条金光大道。也就在这时，一位政治学女老师追了上来，她被弗兰克刚才的演讲深深吸引，那是一种思想的共鸣，一种灵魂的触动。但弗兰克的第一句话却是询问她是否已婚，这突如其来的问题让女老师有些措手不及。弗兰克敏锐地察觉到了这位老师身上的香水品牌，那香气如同一条无形的红线，将俩人的命运紧紧相连。弗兰克通过香水的味道便知道在哪里可以找到女老师。对于弗兰克来说，这不仅仅是一段新的故事，更是他梦想实现的开始。而女老师也许已经开始期待下一次的相遇。随着夕阳的余晖洒在弗兰克的家门口，司机缓缓地将车停靠在了路边。弗兰克转过头对查理投以一个真挚的微笑，他希望查理在圣诞节回家前能再来做客。可还没等查理表达出自己的感激之情，弗兰克已经潇洒地转身，大步流星地走向了自己的家门。查理站在车旁目送着弗兰克的背影，心中充满了感激。随后查理坐上了送他回校的豪车，伴随着车子缓缓启动，查理的思绪也随着车轮的转动而飘远。而那个曾经刻薄总是保持距离的弗兰克，如今却愿意敞开心扉融入这个家庭。他的改变不仅仅是对查理，更是对整个家庭的接纳。他不再是那个冷漠的旁观者，而是成为了这个家庭中不可或缺的一部分。查理与弗兰克两个原本陌生的灵魂，在相互的理解与包容中找到了救赎。他们看到了彼此的伤痛与挣扎，也给予了对方温暖与希望。弗兰克虽双目失明，却能凭借香水的气息感知世界，在探戈与法拉利的飞驰中寻找生命的热度。他的故事告诉我们，即使生活布满阴霾，也要去发现那一抹能点燃内心火焰的色彩，去拥抱激情，去热爱生活的每一个瞬间。那一支探戈是对美好的执着追求， 那一次飞驰是对生命的尽情释放。而查理在困境中面临艰难的选择时，是坚守内心的原则，还是随波逐流换取一时的安逸？在这分叉路口，我们需要有勇气去听从灵魂的声音，去守护那片纯净的道德高地。正如电影中所说，灵魂没有一只，我们不能用妥协和背叛来填补人生的空缺，而应勇敢地捍卫内心的真实，